Well, hello, I'm Kevin Vent here for RCTV, and I have with me a moderator, Alan Foltz. How are you doing today, Alan?
Great. How are you doing, Kevin?
Hanging in there. Your family okay with the virus and all of that?
Everybody's fine. We're sheltering in place. We've been doing everything by the books, and we're doing okay.
Okay. Well, us too, and everything seems to be going okay, so that's I'm glad to hear that. Well, I want to talk to you today a little bit about town meeting, because town meeting is going to be a little different this year. Because of the virus, it was postponed from April to June 15th. And I guess my first question for you, Alan, was, you know, why do we need to have town meeting? Why not just cancel it or not have it until later on in the fall, when maybe things can be done a little more safely?
Sure. Well, the town meeting, of course, is the legislative body of the town. And by state law, one thing that the annual meeting, which is the spring town meeting, must accomplish is to enact a budget for the following fiscal year, which begins on July 1st. So we absolutely need a budget in place by midnight June 30th.
Okay, so it's important to get this done, otherwise the town operations can't function, basically.
Absolutely.
In addition, at least from a financial level.
In addition to the budget, there's a few other financial issues, but the budget is the main thing.
Sure. So the budget is the main driver, along with some other financial issues that need to be taken care of by the town's legislative body. So obviously, town meeting isn't able to meet at the Performing Arts Center the way it normally does, with everybody crowding in there and all that. So what are some of the things that you are doing to ensure that town meeting can happen this year? Is it being virtual, or what's happening with that?
We're having a remote town meeting for the most part, and I'll explain that in just a second. The legislation has just authorized this as of last Saturday evening when the governor signed it.
Wow.
it has to be the choice of the moderator, the platform we use, and I have chosen the Zoom webinar platform. Okay. There may be others, and if this goes on, we may have to look deeper into it, but we had to move fast, so we chose what seemed like the best thing to use, which is Zoom webinar. We are in the midst of giving instructions to town meeting members, and we're going to have a test town meeting this coming weekend that maybe we can talk about a little bit in a minute.
Sure. So talk about first how the Zoom meeting is going to work. Obviously, we're on Zoom right now, so, and it works great with you know, two people talking and having a conversation. But there are 192 members of town meeting who all theoretically could show up for this on Zoom. How do you work that out practically?
Well, as you said, most people are beginning to get used to Zoom or things like it, and they know how it works, basically. But we're not using the regular Zoom system. We're using something called Zoom webinar. I would look at it more like being in a lecture hall, where you're listening to one or two people up front, and you're an attendee at a meeting. Okay. So what we have in the Zoom webinar is we have a panelists, which are made up of myself, the moderator, the town clerk, the town manager, and then we have a Zoom coordinator who will actually be running the show in the background for me while I'm running the meeting.
Okay.
Everybody else will be an attendee, which means that their pictures will not show up, and they will be muted unless I unmute them. So everybody will be able to listen until they are recognized, and then we will unmute them, and then they will talk. Their picture won't come up. It'll just be their name and their precinct.
Okay. So if a member wanted to talk about a particular issue during the meeting, which of course is their right, typically you would call on them, they go to a microphone, they give their name and their precinct, and then they share what they want to share. How is that going to work?
Well, obviously, it's going to be different than a regular town meeting, but we've tried to make it as close as possible to what we would do at the high school. There is a hands-up option in Zoom, and I will be watching for people to raise their hands. Well, I will start off with, in the case of the budget, I will call off on the town manager to give a presentation, and he will be able to share his screen to show his presentation, just like he would down at the Performing Arts Center.
Sure.
When he is done and we've gotten the reports of the Finance Committee and so forth, I then call on the town meeting members for discussion, just like a regular town meeting. Mm-hmm. They will use the hands up option on Zoom, raise their hand, and I'll be watching for those hands. I also have an assistant helping me with that, since this is so different. And I will call them in roughly the order that the hands go up. As we call on them, that person will be unmuted, and then the hands up will be put down.
Sure. Now, typically in a town meeting, when it comes to votes, oftentimes you just raise hands, see how many there are. If you're not sure, you can have people count. You know, we've seen Zoom meetings with government bodies where they do a voice vote, you know, basically, you know, walk, you know, ask everybody to give their vote. How are you going to do votes with this format?
Well, the legislative action gives me wide latitude to do that. I mean, I can do it pretty much the way I would do it in a regular town meeting, but I'm not. We're going to use the polling option in every single case. So we'll have an exact count of everybody who's there. I don't want any questions. In a normal town meeting, seven members could question the vote. Mm-hmm. They're not really going to have the chance to do that this time. So rather than having any question, I'm going to take a polling. We have a separate polling person who actually is our library director who will be setting up these polls as we need them. So the main votes, any amendment proposals that come along, we'll have to quickly make up a poll for that or moving the previous question and so forth.
Right. You're going to take a poll for adjournment?
I will take a poll for adjournment. That might be the one case where I'll take a show of hands. If we know, right. I might go with a show of hands on that one.
Right. So what happens with members of the, specifically town meeting members who maybe can't access Zoom or don't have internet access or might not have the proper equipment? How is that going to work for them?
Well, I've had a two-prong attack on this, both even. One is safety and the other is to make sure no one is disenfranchised.
Sure.
So if you really just cannot work the computer, you don't have a computer, you don't have internet connection, whatever, we have set up the Performing Arts Center to to look something like a standard town meeting. We're hoping to have no more than 10 to 15 people there, but we actually have it spaced out for 60. We can have as many as 60 there. It's a pretty big hall, so we have them spaced out 15, 20 feet apart. We have an usher who will bring you to your seat, and we have a microphone down front that is behind a piece of plexiglass with holes drilled into it. It's a nice frame that the school department has built for us.
Okay.
And I have appointed an assistant moderator who will run things down there and report back to me when somebody at the PAC wants to talk.
Oh, wow. So it's pretty complex. But to be clear, the strong preference is for town meeting members to participate via the Zoom meeting and not to go to the Performing Arts Center unless they really absolutely have to.
Absolutely. That is what that's our preference.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, good. So I know also during town meeting, typically, if a non-member wants to speak, once all the members have spoke, they can do so. Is there a function for that to happen?
Yes, there is. This is a little trickier than in the past, and it's not going to work exactly the way I'd like, but maybe, as I said, if we have to do this in the future, we might be able to work this out. What we're asking non-town meeting members to do is to watch the coverage on RCTV. We've created a special email address. It's called townmeeting@ci.reading.ma.us. You can send your question, your comment, to that email address, along with the specific article that you want to talk about. And assuming it's within the scope of the article, we will have someone read it.
Okay. And if there's a question, the appropriate person will answer it, et cetera.
Correct. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So to be clear, it needs to be on business. That is before town meeting. It can't just be a random comment.
Absolutely. Just like it would be in town meeting.
Yeah. Okay. Very good. So I know this can seem very complex. So what kind of measures have you been taking to maybe prepare in advance for this? Is there any practice coming or you know, have people been playing with the technology or how is that happening?
Good question. Yes, we have. All this week, we have been hosting precinct meetings, which are a normal run-of-the-mill business anyway, precinct meetings. But at each precinct meeting, the town clerk and I have both been attending to give some training after the business of the precinct meeting is over, showing people all of the various functions. There's only a handful of functions. There's the hands up function and the voting function. Those are the main ones. And then being unmuted when you have a chance, when you want to talk. And then stressing to people, don't look for your picture like you would in a normal Zoom. You're not going to find yourself.
Right.
Again, we've done that all week. We've been trying to get the word out. If a town meeting member has not heard about this for whatever reason, please contact the town hall immediately and we'll get you into a meeting. In addition to the eight precinct meetings, on Friday at 3 p.m., we're having a catch-all meeting for anybody who couldn't make it to their meeting or somehow didn't hear about it for this more intimate training. Then on Saturday, we're going to have a test town meeting. We're going to run it just like the Zoom meeting will be on Monday night. We're asking all town meeting members to show up at noon. We're hoping it'll be over in an hour or less. We'll try a couple of articles just to show off all of the various functions of the system.
Okay.
town meeting members should look for a link, an invitation link on Friday evening that will be good for both the Saturday meeting and the Monday meeting.
Okay, very good. And so you have some test articles. I assume you'll allow people to speak on those test articles to kind of test that function and all the other stuff that's going to happen that's a little different this time.
That's right. That's exactly what we're planning.
We should have someone offer an amendment about something crazy.
I actually hope we will, just so we can show off the system.
To show off the system. Well, that's very good. So to be clear, non-town meeting members cannot join the Zoom, but they can watch on RCTV. That's correct?
Yes.
And it will be live on RCTV.
Right. I wish we could do better, but this is the way it has to work this year. And I think we have covered it. They can be involved, and maybe we can smooth that out sometime if we have to in the future.
Absolutely. Well, that sounds like it's going to be quite a process. I'm actually looking forward to seeing how it works. I think it'll be very, very interesting. And you certainly shed some light on some questions that I had that I didn't even understand. So that's good. So I don't know if there's any other information you feel that people need to know about town meeting that's coming up, or have we pretty much covered what we need to?
I would just like to reiterate 2 points. One is you should have heard about the precinct meetings. And if you haven't, call the town hall immediately. And be on the lookout for an email on Friday evening for the test meeting and the showtime on Monday.
Excellent. Hopefully those precinct meetings have been well attended. I know at least in a couple of cases, they actually had to choose some town meeting members at those precinct meetings.
Yes, we've actually had better attendance than we normally do at them.
Well, hopefully that's true for town meeting also. Maybe doing this format will, you know, because I know for a variety of reasons, not every town meeting member attends town meeting every session. And maybe this will actually increase the number of people that are able to attend because of doing it this way.
Well, you know, we don't get to be the first. Lexington was the first one to do this last Monday. And okay. Not to put the pressure on our town meeting members, but they had 186 of 189 show up.
Wow. That's pretty impressive. That's very impressive. Well, thank you, Alan, and thank you for all the work that you and your team have gone into to set this up so that our town government can continue to function as we head towards July 1st. And we look forward, as we said, to seeing what happens at town meeting and how it's going to all work and how the technology is going to come together. My name is Kevin Fent. I've been talking to Alan Foles, who is the moderator of the town of Reading. And this has been a good time we've had here on RCTV talking about this. Take care and have a good day.
Thank you.